Good morning, everyone. My name is Jason Scaria. I'm the Chief Information Officer at Sitel Group. So a little bit about Sitel. We are one of the largest global providers of customer experience solutions and products. We have 160,000 associates that operate in 40 different countries. And what we do is enable customer experiences for over 700 brands. Our associates do this via voice, chat, email, and social media. They experience over 8 million conversations a day in 50 different languages. So our goal is to provide superior customer service through meaningful engagements and increasing brands of our customers. So work from home, like most, was not even something that we considered or thought about for various things. So pre-pandemic, all of our services were delivered in a classic call center. So people came throughout the world. We had large call centers, and that's how we operated. Classic technology stack, Microsoft, SCCM for orchestration and for doing patching, and GPOs for doing policy, ADGPOs. So classic. But because we inherit our customers' applications, we have over for the 700 of those images. So it's not just one image fits all, but we take in 700 of those images and have to do the care and feeding, housekeeping, maintenance for all those particular images. A remote landscape, just before this. So, like most, we had VPN to support corporate people. People work from home and be able to do that while they're traveling. We did have a small VDI instance with another third-party provider. So we had about 3,000 of those that were work from home that did supply support agents. A small WorkSpaces that we were just starting to play with before in 2019. And then clients that actually had embraced work from home had brought their solutions, so about 2,500 of those. But we could never get this. This was never going to be a strategy for us. We couldn't get this off the ground because clients didn't consider they had the same controls of their agent or any of their processes at home as they did in center. Well, 2020 happens and the pandemic starts. So we had to look at what was in our tool bag of how do we get these agents working from home right away. Countries every day were starting to shut down. We're doing stop and suspending operations in center, and we had to react to that. So we had VPN as part of our toolkit. But we did the assessment that with current infrastructure and bandwidth, we can only support about 20,000. Well, we've got 100,000 people that we had to support at that time. We had that VDI provider that was part of that toolkit. But they were experiencing the same challenges that we were experiencing. They couldn't ramp up fast to the deliveries that we were asking for. They didn't have enough infrastructure as well, and they just couldn't get there. So the last thing that we had is that WorkSpaces that we started to look at. And it's like, okay, can we do this? Huge thing for us, even though we want to move people into more of chat, social media, and email, is still voice. Can we get voice working inside of that WorkSpace? And so we were able to. We were just ecstatic when it's like, okay, we've got a couple of soft phones that finally are actually working. So let's go to town with this. This is the only solution that we've got. Let's make this happen. So quickly, we put together our networking teams, our work-at-home engineers, our server engineers, and created this just task team of, like, let's go through the viability of this. We created build teams throughout the globe because we had to start standing up those 700 images. It was every day prioritizing which image we're setting up next, which image we're setting up next, how are we going to get them working, getting these WorkSpaces set up, being able to get these clients working. So everyone's got their journey and their story about the 2020 pandemic. Ours was Friday the 13th, March 13th in 2020. One of our centers shut down in Spartanburg. We had a case there. And so the team had to work all weekend because we sent all of our agents home, and then we're like, how do we get them working on Monday? And so all weekend setting up, again, just working with VPN, but starting to explore what we were able to do with VDIs and getting them there. So we're like, great, let's finish that one. We come in on Monday, Spain closes. In the call center arena, Philippines is a huge market for us. They suspended all in-center operations in that same week. And then lastly, we issued ourselves that too much is going on. We're doing stay-at-home orders for across the globe, for across the U.S. So inside of that week, we had all of those opportunities. By about the end of March, we had EMEA that was doing shutdown orders in almost every country. And so we really had to start ramping up. Literally, I can remember one in Portugal. It was, we're shutting down. You have 4 hours to get out of the office. We asked everyone, just grab your PC and go home. Go make that happen. So a lot of it was that, just take the device that they have and send them home, and you do that via VPN. So we're going through, and it's like, okay, LATAM now shuts down around sometime about April 10th. So we're good. We think, okay, we've managed this. It's been a lot of work. We're going through every day. And we got to the end of April and was like, all right, we've got a combination of VPN users. We've got workspaces that are working. We've actually been able to preserve revenue. We're taking calls again. This is all working well. What happens to good IT teams that are successful? You just get more work. So what happened to us? Our salespeople decided to say, hey, let's sell this capability. You guys are able to do things that other BPOs are just not able to get done there. And so they were successful in selling it. They sold to InEMEA, a national health provider, taking over their COVID response and track and trace for the entire country. Fantastic, except we sold it on 5/8. They wanted to go live in 3 weeks, and they wanted it at peak, ramped to 35,000 agents. So it was like, what are we going to do? One of the classic lines, I think, from Jim, who's here, and from his team, is bring it on. We've had the workspace experience now. We can absolutely do that kind of ramp. So within the first 2 weeks, we were able to ramp and go live with 10,000 agents, and then eventually move off to 35,000 agents. So really getting that done. We had to take over their processes, another outsource provider, and then ramp to all of these agents that are out there. So what did that end up meaning for us? We started with 300 workspaces, and then our capability within the first 25 days, we were able to spin up another 10, and then we run that track and trace program, and we were able to spin up another 20,000 workspaces in just 16 days. So it just, I don't know of anything else that was in our toolkit that would allow us that particular capability. It was just amazing. So results, everything is about results. What does it mean? Lastly, that we continue to do PCI certification. So we were like, all right, it's our current rock. This now is a part of our tool. Let's try this out. And we had to, a surprise of many of us is like we were able to actually get the solution PCI certified. So we've got it now. It's like you can't use that objection anymore. Where do we sit today? So right now, we have completely pivoted. We have started the acceleration of shutting down centers. Work at home is here to stay. Work at home is absolutely going to be part of how we deliver services. Right now, we have about 65,000 virtual associates that are taking calls for our brands every day. 30,000 is about where we run with workspaces. So that's absolutely part of our key components for that solutions. We're operating work at home in 40 countries. So you name the particular challenge that you have in the Philippines. Often an agent is sitting in a multi-generational home, and they're working U.S. hours, and we're having to struggle with what's going on with, why is it that their call quality and audio is so bad? We started listening, and it's because they were whispering on the call, because their grandparents are sleeping in the same room, and they're taking calls on behalf of our U.S. clients. So it was fascinating to understand just what does work at home mean in each of these different countries? And then lastly, with revenue, we started 2020, clients saying that we may be out of business. So that meant no revenue for us. We didn't know what the future held for us. We ended 2020 doing 18% year-over-year growth and doing our best revenue year ever. It was fantastic. So not all just business, right? What did it mean to agent experience? And this is probably the best story that we love. So when we polled our work-at-home people, we had 32% lower absenteeism, 27% lower attrition, and better schedule adherence in that you have to roll out of bed, take a shower, and you're at work. So it was great. And then when we polled, 82% prefer this way to work. We don't want to come in the center anymore. We'd rather do this. So it was a fantastic solution for us.